Hey y'all, Billy Thomas here, and today we're going to take a look at installing SQL Server Integration Services, which is what you're going to need if you're trying to import or export data in and out of SQL Server. All right, let's get to work. We're here in SSMS, and we want to import or export data. So the way you normally do that is you would use an import-export wizard. So if we come down here and type in import, and we hit this guy, we get this error which says SQL Server Integration Services Wizard has not been was not prepared to handle blah blah blah. Basically, you've got to install SQL Server Integration Services to import and export data and use DTS functionality, right? So I'm going to show you how to do that. What you want to do is go to, and this comes up but it doesn't work. You want to go to your Windows menu, you want to hit All Apps, and go down till you find Microsoft SQL Server, and you want to hit this guy right here, SQL Server Installation Center. You want to click that, yes, allow changes, and then we want to go over here to Installation, and then this first guy, New SQL Server Standalone Install, or, this is what we're doing, Add Features to an Existing Installation. Now this is important. If you don't get the directories right here, it's not going to let you do the install. So you're going to have to come down here, and for me, where I put this was SQL Server 2022, and I'm using the developer edition. You have to use the developer edition if you want SSIS to work. So I'm going to click that and hit OK. Now it will work. You will get an error if you hit the wrong directory. So now we just got to give this a moment or two. We let it do the processing, and then I've got to show you a couple screens that we've got to work our way through. And again, if you don't hit the right thing, you're not going to get there. So just stay tuned. We'll be right back. Okay, we've made progress, and it comes up here where it says Install Rules. Now, it's giving me a warning about the Windows Firewall. We can go ahead and proceed past that. Now it's saying, what are we doing here? Well, we're not doing a new install. We're adding features to our SQL Server, and we'll hit Next here. Then we don't want to use this Azure extension, so we can just uncheck that. That'd be another video. And here we go. Now we're getting into the stuff we're looking for. What we want is this guy right here. It says Shared Features, and it says Integration Services. That boy right there, Integration Services. And then if we hit Next, we give it a second, we wait. Okay, we come up to just a Next screen, nothing really to do there, and Install. Discovering, and so on and so forth. All right, here we go. We'll give it a minute. We are making progress. Looks like we're just about done here. Yay. Integration services succeeded. That is the communication you're looking for. So if we close this, and now we say we can close this install center here. If we run the import and export wizard, no error. And now you should be able to import and export data, and we'll come back to that in the next video. So hey, if you like what you're seeing here and this is helpful, why don't you go ahead and like this video, subscribe to the channel, and remember, it's all joy data, because working with data should make you smile.